From Haiti, West 2's Gail Pascal Brown is live downtown with Gary Siplin and other local leaders. And Gail, he apparently has some very close ties to that nation.
Absolutely. Senator Gary Sipling's wife is Haitian-American, Victoria Pierre Sipling. And of course, all of this rings near and dear to the throngs of folks who are out here from local churches, both Christian and Haitian. And today, basically, they're going to launch Operation Hope for Haiti, sort of putting everything under one umbrella. And we're going to turn in now to listen to Senator Gary Sipling and others describe basically what this organization is going to do and how they can get people to get the help in Haiti where it's needed. Senator Sipling.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Pastor Max Charles, and I would like to begin by first welcoming our elected officials, clergymen, distinguished guests, members of the press. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Haitian community, we would like to thank you all for your humanitarian spirit, which has been demonstrated by your presence here and abroad. Again, we welcome each and every one of you that are here today. Let's bow our heads for prayer. Heavenly Father, we call on you at this moment. We pray that you will be with us, that you would inspire and bring much needed hope and restoration. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. At this time, it is my honor to introduce to you our State Senator Gary Sipling.
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
On Tuesday, January 12, 2010, at approximately this same time, an earthquake measuring 7.0 on the Richter scale struck near Port-au-Prince, Haiti, followed by multiple aftershocks. We know that this tragedy was shaken, has shaken the Haitian community, and we have come together in a unified manner today to show our unwavering support and dedication. Many Haitian American citizens are concerned about the well-being of family members still in Haiti. As a state senator of Florida, I urge the community in every area of this great state to assist organizations to provide the immediate aid to this area. Haiti will need your long-term commitment of assistance as they begin to rebuild their country, which will take many years to reestablish itself as a viable country. We have confirmed that the Port-au-Prince Airport is still closed to all but aid flights from the United States government. This does not stop our efforts of collecting funds in mass qualities and quantities of first aid kits, medical supplies, blankets, towels, washcloths, hygiene products, and antibodies.
All right. As you can hear, Senator Sipling is basically giving information about Operation Hope for Haiti. He, as well as other members, Daisy Lynham with Orange Orlando City Council and Sam Ings and other members of the church group here, the launch that they're going to give, it's www.operationhopeforhaiti.org, and we, of course, will be adding that to our website. The whole idea here, again, is to bring all of these various communities together on one umbrella. They want to let the folks know that this operation is available and can help people. We, of course, will have more coming up a little bit later on West 2 News. I'm Gail Pascal Brown, now live in front of the City Hall steps with the group Operation Hope for Haiti. Now back to you in the studio.